The excitement of Christmas and bringing in the new year are now over, and some places are still snowy and cold. Sometimes the winter season can seem to drag on a little long. So today, let's paint our way through the winter blues and turn our canvas into a snowy wonderland. But I do have to warn you, it's going to be so much fun. Oh, okay, that was a bad one, but I couldn't help myself. All right, let's get started.
All right, let's gather up our art supplies, including watercolor paper, watercolor paints, and some clean water, along with a medium-sized round brush. I will be using a number 8 Artegria round, and let's get started. Now, really quickly, using a pencil, I am going to sketch a simple and quick outline for this painting. This really isn't hard to do. I believe in you and I think you can do it, but if you'd rather, I do have a slightly more detailed outline available for sale on my Etsy shop if you'd rather go that route. I'll have a link for that, as well as a list and links for all the supplies you will see me using today in the description of this video. Okay, I'm going to start this by drawing a simple mountain with just one peak, about a third of the way down from the top of the page. Then I've got just under that sort of a slanted hill that moves down and then back up. Then we'll draw one more hill about two-thirds of the way down the page with a dip in the middle. Now I'll just pencil in some lines on these hills for some of the pine trees that we'll be painting later. I'll make the tree lines smaller in the back hill and a little taller in the hill that's in front. In fact, I think I'll have a couple of really tall ones here on the left side that stretch way up into the sky. All right, down here at the bottom of the page, I would like to have some marks for some shadows in the snow. Now, yours don't have to be exactly like mine, but you do want to have the shadows follow kind of the same curve or dip as the hills above to keep it looking like it's moving down through the rest of the page. And really quick, I think I'll add a couple more taller trees here on this right side as well, and maybe some smaller ones in between them. I'll go ahead and draw a few more shadow marks in the snow here, and I may add in one more tall tree off to this left side. And as a side note, the sketch I sell on Etsy, I actually have drawn some outlines for the pine tree branches, if that's helpful for you. But for the painting today, I think that we can just shape those in with our paint and brush. Now at this point, I'm pretty much done here. I'll just add a few small bush or branch-like twigs at the base of these larger forefront trees to add in a little bit of detail. Because I'll be using quite a bit of water today, I am going to tape my paper down with artist tape to help prevent some of the warping, and then we're ready to paint. This piece today is fairly monochromatic in color. I'm using mostly blue colors, but we will be playing a lot with the values. Here I've got some ultramarine blue, and then some cerulean blue. But since they are fairly similar in value right now, I think I will add a touch of ivory black to the ultramarine blue to darken it, as well as tone down the vibrancy a little bit. I'll start by painting in the sky area first using just water. Then I'll add some of this lighter and brighter cerulean blue to the area and blend it in. Now I'm kind of focusing the color more on the top and the center of this section, partly because the sides are eventually going to have pine trees covering up a lot of that space. While I wait for the sky to dry, I'm actually going to come down here to the bottom of the painting and paint some of these shadows in the snow. So let's add a little bit of burnt umber to our tray. I'll start by adding some water to this section first on the right side that spreads out from under the trees. Then I'll paint in some of the darkened ultramarine blue right under the trees and spread it out to the other side. Then I'll add in some more of this color on the far left side as well. Now I'll add just a touch of the brown and blend it in with this blue area, just to give it a little bit of variety. Now I'll go ahead and paint these other shadow areas in a very similar way. But be cautious when using the brown. Use it very sparingly. You only want to have a little bit here and there. I will tell you also, this painting doesn't look like much until you add in the finishing touches more at the end. So don't get discouraged or give up halfway through thinking it doesn't look good. Stick it out and keep going to the end, and I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. My goal with this channel is to help you feel like you can achieve and finish a lovely piece of artwork that makes you proud, as well as maybe learning some tips and techniques in the process. If this is something you're looking for, I hope you'll subscribe. All right, now that the sky is pretty much dry, I'm going to come back in here and water down this mountain section. Then I'll start applying some watered down or lighter valued ultramarine blue and ivory black mixture. I'm painting this color along the top edge here, and then I'll spread it more to the bottom area, and I'd really like that color to fade or get lighter as I move downward. So if I need to, I'll even add in a little more water to achieve that look. Then while the mountain is still a little damp, I'll paint in some small tree shapes following some of those pencil lines that I drew in earlier. Now, because this area is damp, these trees will sort of blur or bleed, but I kind of like that look here because it helps create that look of them being farther away. Then after I have a good little outline of the treetops, I'll actually spread some of this color down to the pencil line. Next, I'll add in another line of trees along this line here, also letting them fade and blur slightly. Now, before moving on to the next part, we actually need this section to dry completely. So you can go grab a cup of hot chocolate or something and wait for it to dry on its own, or you can cheat like me and dry it quicker with a hairdryer today. I'm also going to freshen up and add more pigment to my ultramarine and ivory black mixture to make it a little darker and more concentrated for this next hillside. Then again, I'll add water to the area first, and then add the dark blue at the top, forming a line of distant pine trees, and then fading that color to almost nothing as I near the bottom of this section. For this next part, we're going to paint in a few of these larger and taller pine trees using a variety of colors and values. So really quickly, let's mix some ultramarine blue with some Hooker's green to make a very pretty blue-green color. And I'll actually add extra water to this right now to keep it lighter in value also. Then I'll paint in a rough shape of the pine trees here using just water first along the pencil line from earlier. And now I'll start painting in some loose pine trees. I'll paint a couple of light brown umber ones on the edges here just to add a fun variety. And then I'll test out some of this blue-green that we just made. Then later, I'll move on to some of the darker ultramarine blue as well. And as I add each tree, I'm going to allow them to blend and spread into each other so the colors touch near the bottoms. I'll finish off this hillside with a little bit of water and burnt umber, and then let's dry this painting completely before moving on to the final steps of this painting that really make this picture pop. I'm going to quickly darken up this blue-green color now, as well as add some Hooker's green and ivory black for a nice dark green, and maybe even some pure ivory black for the trunks and twigs. Starting with an ivory black trunk, we'll begin painting these final foreground trees. Now, this time I am not putting water on the paper first. This is also known as the wet on dry technique. Then, starting at the top of the tree, I'll paint some blobs or shapes that can loosely represent pine branches moving down the tree. I'll use a variety of colors that I just mixed up, and I'll gradually make the branches larger and probably even darker in value as I move down. And keep in mind, these are fairly loose. I am not painting on tiny little individual pine needles here. We're going for shapes that can represent and create an overall look of a pine tree. I'll go ahead and add in two more background pine trees next to this first one, keeping the tops of them slightly separate from each other so you can see that there are multiple trees. But then as we move down, we're going to blend them and mix them together nearer the bottom. And I forgot to paint the trunks on these two, so I will go ahead and do that now. But I don't think I'll paint the line clear to the top this time, maybe just halfway up the tree. Now that these are painted in, I feel like I need to add even more darker values in here closer to the bottom half of these trees. And as you probably know, to get a darker paint, use a more concentrated blend of pigment and less water in your colors. Okay, let's do that same thing here on this other side of the page now. Thank you. All right, well done. For our last little detail to this painting, let's add in some of these little twigs at the base of the pine trees using some ivory black and the very tip of your brush. Then, if you'd like, when the painting is fully and completely dry so you don't get any smearing, you can try erasing some of these pencil marks that might still be showing. And that's it for today's beautiful wintry landscape. I hope you had some fun painting with me today. If you did enjoy this tutorial, please consider subscribing to my channel so I can continue to help you discover your artistic side.